Hello again and welcome back to the Aji Show and another exciting edition of the Useless Skill Challenge. This episode we attack head-on the nefarious puzzle device known round the world as Rubik's Cube. This seemingly innocent little puzzle was invented in 1974 by a Hungarian sculptor and architecture professor named Erno Rubik. It wasn't even created originally as a puzzle, but as a test to teach his students to visualize three-dimensional objects and how to build something where all the pieces moved independently without the whole thing falling apart. He didn't even know he had invented a puzzle until he scrambled up his first device and came to realize quickly how hard it was to put back together. He licensed it to a Hungarian toy company the next year, and they began selling it under the name The Magic Cube. But I think the Hungarians really missed an opportunity here. Every nation on Earth would be speaking Hungarian as a first language right now if they had given this to their army instead of selling it as a toy. Just think, you've got a prisoner in the cell, and you want to know what the missile codes are. Leave him alone with this thing for an hour, come back, and
I'll tell you whatever you want to know. Just give me a hint.
Or better yet, just drop them behind enemy lines out of a plane. Yeah, oh yeah, the fighting. Can you come back in a little while? I've almost got all the yellows put together. The cube spread quickly around the world and became a ubiquitous household item. Most people probably have one, and I bet most people watching this video have solved a Rubik's Cube at some point. Though I'm willing to bet that 99% of you did it by peeling off the little stickers. Full disclosure, I already knew how to solve the cube going into this episode. In fact, solving a cube is a favorite part of my show. I race audience members, me solving a cube and them completing a simple children's puzzle.
I have yet to be beaten.
Although, one time I did get a little cocky and let four Navy officers in full dress uniform try to solve the puzzle together, and they came the closest of anyone so far. That was terrifying. So my goal this week was to learn a little more about this, the world's best-selling toy, and improve my time so as to never come that close to defeat again. I wanted to get my solves consistently under a minute, which by your average person's scorecard is pretty fast, but for a speed cuber, is amateurishly slow. The current world record for solving a 3x3x3 cube at international competition was set by an Australian named Felix Zemdegs at a competition in Melbourne in 2011. His time, 5.66 seconds.
5.66 seconds. That's this fast.
That's ridiculous! And here I am, doing everything I can to solve it in under a minute. In doing my research, I found one step that I thought I could conquer in a week. It involves memorizing 7 new algorithms and turning my 4-look last layer into a 3-look last layer. Now what that means is I focused on one specific step in my solve to try and make it faster by memorizing 7 patterns of shifting the cube. That way I could get on to the next step in one move rather than several. It's the difference between this and this. What I discovered was that those 7 patterns, even though they increased my average time and helped me best my previous record, got it all the way down to 50.82 seconds, were not enough. That step alone could not help me achieve the results that I wanted this week. Turns out, my real problem wasn't later in the solve with these steps, but earlier. The first 3 steps are taking me sometimes up to 40 seconds to complete, just on their own. And that is much too slow. I feel like any real gains I made this week were simply because I had worked on the cube so much more intensely than usual, rather than the measly second or second and a half I got from those 7 new patterns I learned. Though don't get me wrong, I'm glad I worked on them, I'm glad I memorized them, because a second and a half's gonna come in real handy. It's alright, I understand that moving forward from here, each second that I shave off of my average time is gonna take much more work to achieve than the second before it. There aren't really any more quick fixes or simple answers for me here. That's okay though, I'm a juggler. I'm built specifically for hours, weeks, and months of repetitive practice. So next time you're down at Pier 39 in San Francisco or happen to catch one of my shows around the globe, don't forget to raise your hand and try your luck at the Rubik's Cube Challenge. And while you're at it, hit the subscribe button or like the Aji Show on Facebook to keep up to date with all the latest goodies. Or you can follow me on Tumblr for all the little blog posts in between the episodes. And I'll see you next week, the Internet, when we elevate the humble ping pong ball to newfound levels of glory. I really thought that was going to go in there.